All right, so we're going to start off with a long sequence of stretches for the whole body. First, we're going to start with our neck. I'm going to look towards this side, lean down, and I'm going to pull gently my neck in that direction. We want to inhale through our nose, slow exhales through our mouth. Then we're going to switch sides. Exact same thing on this side. Gently pull. Each stretch, we're going to try to hold for a minute. We're going to go down the center. Gently pull. Elbows come together. Next thing is going to be a shoulder stretch. So put my hands behind me, like so. I'm going to pull my shoulders back, scoot my butt forward until you feel a nice stretch in the shoulders, and then we're just going to breathe. We're going to hold that for 1 to 2 minutes. The next thing is going to look like this. We're going to be in somewhat of a child's pose. I'm going to start with both hands in front of me. I'm going to take my right hand, put it right in front of my left hand. Then I'm going to pull my body away, keeping this top hand anchored. And I'm pulling my body diagonally. I want to get a nice stretch across this side of my body right here. We're going to take big inhales and slow exhales. Then we'll switch. Left hand right in front of the right hand. Pull my body away. Keep that hand anchored. Big inhales. Let your head hang here. That'll be about a minute to 2 minutes per side. Then I'm gonna walk my hands forward. And I'm going to try to get my chest and forehead to the ground. That's going to be about 1 to 2 minutes in that position. The next thing we call a pretzel. It's a variation of a pretzel. So here's how we set up. I'm going to have my legs in this position. So they're both bent. The top of this foot is on top of this leg. I'm gonna take this hand and I'm gonna put it right in front of my knee. This hand's here, and I'm slowly gonna come down, and I'm basically twisting my torso away from this knee, and I'm just gonna breathe. You wanna make it a little more intense? Bring this elbow to the ground. And then breathe again. You want to push through this hand, get a little bit more rotation, and breathe. If you're really mobile, that might be what you need. Most people will be good here or here. So we're going to do about 2 minutes per side on each side. So the other side would look like this, top foot on top of this leg. Hands right here in front of the knee. I'm gonna come down nice and low and breathe. Again, you need more stretch in that. We could bring the elbow down and breathe. You should feel somewhere in here. This is a big global stretch. It's not necessarily pinpointing one part of your body. The next thing is going to be a stretch for our hips. So, much like what we just did, now the knee angle is a little bit more open. I'm going to try to align this part of my body with my leg, keep my chest up and fold forward. If I keep my back straight, which looks like this, you should feel your hip. If I start to round my back, that might be okay for some of you that are tight. You're still feeling a good stretch. But if you're a little bit more mobile, keep that back straight and fold down to really emphasize what's going on right here. And that is the goal. So we're gonna do both sides. This is my right side. And when I'm done, switch to the other side. Here, we wanna keep a nice 90 degree angle here. And I'm gonna fold down again, connect it with the breath. So we're gonna take a big inhale. Slow exhales. From there, we're gonna move on to a ankle stretch. So we're gonna get into what we call the combat position or half kneeling position. And I'm here. So now I'm gonna bring this heel a little close to this knee, and I got a lot of body weight coming through my arm onto the top of my leg. I'm trying to keep my heel connected to the ground, and I'm just gonna start to lean forward. So right in here. So I have most of my weight going through the front of my foot, but I'm still trying to keep this heel connected to the ground, and I'm just gonna breathe in this position. You should feel a nice stretch somewhere along this area, and that's what I feel. You might feel a little something in here if you're tight in that part of your hips, that's okay. And we just breathe here. One to 2 minutes on that side, then we'll switch. Same thing applies here. I have a lot of weight on this hand or elbow, shifting my weight this way, keeping the connection to the ground, and I'm trying to get this knee as far over the toe as I can, and we're gonna breathe. If you're tight in here, that might get intense. From there, we're gonna move on to a hamstring stretch. So the hamstring stretch, we're gonna get into what we call a herbivore's position, which looks like this. If you're really tight in your hamstring, you may need to put something underneath your butt, like a couple towels or a pillow, and that'll help you get into this stretch a little bit more easily. But what we're gonna do is we're just gonna fold forward. That's it. It's okay to have this knee a little bit bent. It doesn't need to be perfectly locked out. So if I fold forward, head or nose is going towards the foot. And again, we're breathing deeply. It's all about the breath with these stretches, okay, guys? So big inhale, slower exhales. Once we're done with this side, we'll go into the other side. Same thing here. You want to hold this stretch for at least 1 minute, up to 2 minutes, maybe even longer if it's feeling good. From there, we're gonna go into the both legs at the same time. So we're going to a seated forward fold, which looks like this. I'm gonna have a little bit of bend in my knee, and then we're just gonna fold forward. Let your body weight just kind of help you get into the position. Don't force anything. These are passive stretches. It should calm the nervous system down. So when we're here, we're breathing, I would say 2 minutes in this position. Remember, big inhale in through the nose, slower exhales through the mouth. From there, we're gonna go back into our hurdler stretch. This time, we're gonna try to stretch the front of our leg, which is our quad position. So here, pull this leg back. I'm gonna take this hand this time and pull my heel or my foot towards my butt. Then I'm gonna lean back onto my elbow right here. Boom. So from this position, I'm trying to push this hip forward while pulling this foot towards my butt, right in here. Again, deep breaths. 1 to 2 minutes on this side, 1 to 2 minutes on this side. On this side, I'm a little tighter, so my stretch isn't gonna look as good here, but I need it more. So right here. If you have a big imbalance between sides, I recommend doing the side that's tighter a little longer. From here, we're gonna do our crescent lunge stretch. So now we're working on the front of the body. It's gonna look like this, Simba. So we're gonna be here. If you need to put something underneath this knee because it's a little painful, that's okay. We're just gonna shift our hips forward like this. So ideally, we're feeling a big stretch here, keeping my chest up, and I'm just gonna breathe. Trying to hold at least 1, maybe 2 minutes of this side, then we're gonna switch. Same exact thing here, chest up, shift forward, and breathe. For me, this side's a lot tighter, so I generally hold this left side in another 1 to 2 minutes more than this side. And then from there, we're gonna go into our Sphinx pose, which looks like this. We're gonna come down to the ground. Elbows are right underneath my shoulders. I am going to imagine that I have a light shining out of my sternum and the beam is facing down right now, so I wanna make that beam face up. So I'm gonna rotate my upper back up by pushing my elbows into the ground, and right here you're really going to feel the power of the breath. So we're going to inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth, trying to pull my chin in more here. We don't want to be here like this. We don't want to overextend our neck. So right here, coming from the back, mid back to upper back, pushing through these elbows. Big inhales. If you do this correctly, you're gonna feel the lower belly pushing into the ground. I recommend at least 2 minutes, maybe more. If you have lower back pain, this is an amazing stretch for that. After that, we're gonna go into our scorpion pose. So from here, extend this arm out. We're gonna look away and cross our leg over like this. Look away. Big deep breaths in that position. Again, 1 to 2 minutes per side. Extend this arm, look away, cross this over. Hold this for 1 to 2 minutes. And then from there, we're gonna do our reclining spinal twist pose. So we're gonna go onto our back now. Everyone's favorite, hands go out to the side, pull the knees in, we'll go ahead and let them fall to one side, right here, look away, and just breathe deeply. You could spend 1, 2, 5 minutes in this position. Gently come up to the middle, go to the other side, another 1 to 2 minutes here. If your leg is trying to pop up like mine is on this side, you could take this arm and gently push it down to get a little bit more stretch. From there, we're just gonna go into our corpse or savasana, right here. Find a comfortable place. Up to 5 minutes here. Just find that peaceful spot. And you're done.